In this movie, we're going to have a look at the locators and explore some of the things we can do with them. So the locators, you may remember, are two points you can define in the ruler in the timeline of your logic project. So here I have a left and a right locator. And you can have them in cycle mode or off, but the locators are always there. To set the locators, there's a number of things you can do. For example, you can simply click and drag in the ruler here, and it sets the left and right locators. You can also change the position of the left or right locator by grabbing it and moving it. And you can move the two of them together by clicking in the middle and dragging like so. In addition, you can see that I have the LCD display set up in custom view. And what that means is that I can see the position of the left and the right locator because I've set it up so that it'll show me that. Now I can just go ahead and double click and type in positions for the left or the right locators. Now, when you have the left and right locators in cycle mode, of course, logic's going to play from the locators. And if you set it up with a cycle of, let's say, two bars here, of course, logic will play in a looping manner just from the left and the right locator over and over and over again. In addition, you'll find in the key command list, you can set up some key commands that will let you have also some options for working with the locators for both locating and playback. So for example, I have myself set up with a key command to go to the left locator and to go to the right locator, also to play from the left locator and play from the right locator. And you can find those key commands in the key command list, and you can assign them to some keyboard strokes on your computer if you want to use those on a regular basis as you work. In addition, there's some editing commands you can work with that also use the locators, and you can find them in the edit menu here, although this toolbar is set up to also show you some of those options. So for example, here, I might say, well, I want to take away some of the drumming from this ghost track. Let's say I don't really want to have that play for those two bars, bar 13 and 14. So what I can do is go down here and I can say split this region by the locators. And it turns out there's a note that's hanging over either bar 13 or bar 15, and I can say keep it, split it, or most likely I would say go ahead and just shorten it. And now I have that region by itself, and if I want, I can go ahead and delete it. I'm going to hit undo a couple times, go back to where I was. You'll also find other commands that you can use with the locators for doing some editing work. For example, I can actually make a selection here that spans, in this case, bar 11 to bar 17, which is really this section of the song here. And I can say, well, maybe I don't want this section of the song. I want to get rid of it. So what I can do is say, let's go ahead and cut that section. And it just took away those bars and it shuffled all the rest of my MIDI regions to the left. Or I could go the other way and I can say, well, look, I really like, let's say, for example, this part here. And I want it to play one more time before it moves on to the next section here. So I can say, let's repeat this section. And now it's going to repeat that section. You can see that it made a copy of all of these regions here over to here. I'll hit undo one more time. And as you explore the edit menu, you'll find a couple of other commands related to the locators for doing some editing. And this is also true if you start going through the key command list. In addition, you'll find that if you right click or control click right on the actual locators, you can see there's a number of these items available to you here with a little pop-up, including some interesting things. One of them is that you can actually swap the position of the left and the right locators. So right now, my left locator is at bar 17, right locator is at bar 23. If I swap them, you can see now the right locator actually comes before the left locator. And the cycle display here looks a little funny. Well, what's going to happen now is that instead of playing those bars in a cycling manner, what I can do is start playback before we get here, and logic will actually skip over these bars and continue playing after the locator, which is really the left locator, at bar 23. So. And that's a really handy feature if you have a really big project and you want to, for example, play the first section and then maybe the third section of the piece and just skip over the second section just to see how that feels. You can quickly set it up by setting up the locators, then go ahead and swap the locator positions. And then when you hit play, it'll simply skip over that particular span of bars from the right to the left locator. So those are some things to look into for working with the locators in Logic.